Let us begin today's Mass with the hymn From With Joyful Lips, number A124.
Neither dew nor rain these years, except by my word. And the word of the Lord came to him, depart from here and turn eastwards and hide yourself by the brook Cherith, which is east of the Jordan. You shall drink from the brook, and I have commanded the ravens to feed you there. So he went and did according to the word of the Lord. He went and lived by the brook Cherith, that is east of the Jordan. And the ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning, and bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the brook. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response be, our help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Please repeat. From where shall come my help? My help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Your response, our help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will keep your foot from stumbling. Your guard will never slumber. No, he sleeps not, nor slumbers, Israel's God. Your response, our help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. The Lord your God, the Lord your shade, at your right hand, by day the sun shall not smite you, nor the moon in the night. Your response, our help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. The Lord will guard you from evil. He will guard your soul. The Lord will guard your going and coming, both now and forever. Your response, our help shall come from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Please stand for the acclamation.
Alleluia. God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when others revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For so they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel passage that we have just read is from the book of Matthew, or according to Matthew. And from today onwards, we shall begin the readings from the Gospel of Matthew. We will be reading it for 3 weeks or around. For this passage is also called as a Sermon on the Mount, for it is the compendium of the doctrine of the right behavior. And the introduction that we have read today about this whole compendium of right behavior summarizes what it is all about. The readings begin with, it is said that seeing the crowd, Jesus went up on the mountain. So Matthew would like to portray that Jesus is now proclaiming from the mountain. And why does he do so? Because Matthew writes to the Jews, and Jews have a high regard for the laws. And the law given by Moses on the mountain of Sinai. So there's one law which is given from the mountain of Sinai, and Matthew would like to tell the disciples that, well, this is the new law that has been proclaimed from this mount by Jesus Christ. And what is this new law all about? We shall see it through the whole sermon. As one person rightly summarizes this law and says, it is the revolution of love. So he would like to proclaim that this law is given from the mountain, and this is the new law which Jesus proclaims. And what does this law give us? And Jesus would say that it gives us blessings. And that's why he begins this summary by saying blessed. Blessed is much more than happiness. The word happiness is itself a shallow word, but it is much more than happiness. And blessed is something that gives you the joy that you would like to. And therefore, how do you get this? How do you get this blessedness? It is the natural way that we understand, or something reverses that natural way. And how do we understand, or how do we think that we may get happiness or blessedness? We say that if we get a lot of wealth, then we may be happy. Or if we get a power that we desire, we may be happy. Or if we are influential, we may be happy. Or we may attain certain pleasures and we may be happy. But Jesus reverses this type of natural understanding of happiness. And he would say that you examine your desires and attitude. Where is your treasure? How do you deal with people? And therefore, he begins by saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. It does not mean that poor by itself is a blessing. I would rather say it's It is some sort of being under discomfort, being under hardship, and nobody likes hardship or discomfort. But when Matthew writes this, he would rather say that you need to be dependent on God. Poor are the ones who are dependent on God. The wealth or whatever they are getting, many of them would say, it is through my own effort. I have done that. And therefore, when I come into picture, I don't need God. And therefore, Matthew would say, you are blessed if you are dependent on God, because you are poor in spirit and you trust in the Lord. We have an example in today's first reading of Elijah. Elijah was dependent on God. Therefore, when God tells him that you have to speak against Ahab and all the things that he does, and I will be with you, he depended on God and he went ahead. He was fed by the ravens. He drank from the brook. So he was dependent and he was happy with regard to that. He was blessed. And the blessings of God flowed through him. So therefore, we see over here that one who is dependent on God is always having an attitude of being loved by God. And therefore, this attitude also reaches out to others. He loves others. He fights or is working for the justice for the poor or the needy. He helps out people who are in need. So therefore, this attitude also flows from it, from the desire of being dependent upon God. And all the other things that follows, like for example, the next thing that it says, blessed are those who mourn. There is some sort of a loss. And you cannot be happy when there is a loss in you. There is something that is lacking. It is only God who is providing it to you. So my dear brothers and sisters, today's reading invites us to examine our desires in life. What is our focus? Where is our treasure? Am I also in a hurry to attain money, wealth, power, influence, or pleasure? Or there is something much more to it? The pandemics of today invites us again also to examine this. Wealth cannot give you happiness. Power cannot give you happiness. Influence cannot give you happiness. But there is something which is much more than that which can make you blessed. And this is the right desire that we need to cultivate. And the right attitude of showing compassion towards others. And if we have this, the right action will automatically flow from our lives. Let us ask the grace to help us to cultivate this right desire and right attitude in our lives.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of our human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be acceptable oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity. To Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so, it is right that all our creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, all our saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy.
Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us ask the grace of Almighty God, who shows us in this prayer that we need to be dependent on him, that he may purify our desires and attitude. Let us pray to him.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in
communion and experience the presence of Jesus in our hearts. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil, and lead us to what is right. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Let us call upon Mother Mary and we pray the prayer that Pope Francis has given us. O Mary, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. O dear Mother, you know what we need. We are sure you will provide it to us, so that, as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us to the cross, to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Under your protection, we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of us who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Let us sing the hymn From With Joyful Lips, number C54. What thanks, O Lord, can I render thee for all the gifts thou hast showered on me? Each day I sing of thy praise and glory. Alleluia, alleluia. Give thanks to the Lord upon the harp. With a ten-string you sing him songs. Oh, sing him a song that is new. Play loudly with all your skill. What thanks, O Lord,